Welcome to this video playing WGM Giovanni from Russia. Irina Sudakova, okay. That once, let's, okay. At least not the g4 line with knight c3, and not that it is so brilliant, but this is a line that requires some more concrete knowledge, and I really don't know the theory too well in this opening. Really? Well, that surprises me. Why do you want to exchange? I thought that this would help me. Okay. Where to go? Probably here. This knight is B6 knight is going to D5. Yeah, this kind of structure is always a bit tricky because black gets the D5 square, but he's suffering a bit from lack of space. What about C5? Is this, I mean, g4 is the idea, and I need to move the knight probably back somewhere. But if I play c5, I'm attacking d4. The only question is this an untimely idea with black not being fully developed? But I still like it. I still like it. Using the unprotected state of the queen. Yeah, it's probably the right decision anyway. g4, I take on g4. Yeah, this is the conventional way to play, and probably the right one. Okay, grab here and trade pieces. Okay. I just thought taking and knight d5 is the easiest way to play. However, knight d7 attacking e5. Yeah, well, probably not. Let's just put it on d5. This is the big asset that black has, the great square on d5. And you should really use it. Yeah, should I give the check? And I have some coordination issues. This bishop here and knight. My bishop on f8 is not able to move. What about bishop b4? Yeah.
Check.
Okay, well, let's get rid of one rook. I'm not sure at all, but
check.
This was my
check.
Idea. Using this tempo on the rook or the king. But how to play now? If I go king d7 and knight c3, I can take with the bishop. There's a3, however. Yeah, it's a bit tricky this position. My bad development is a serious issue. Okay, still, let's do that. a3, I'm going here. Knight c5, king c6, I don't think.
Check.
I thought this would be okay. Yeah, but this rook c4, simply rook c4. Maybe here, maybe go here. And go to b8. I know, it looks creepy. But I don't see a direct problem. Check to I go to A8.
Check.
Or to C7. Maybe here. It's no. Intending B6. B6, King B7. Maybe at the end, this knight can prove a liability. B6 is basically trapping the knight. And then King B7, Bishop D8. At the end, the knight has no square. Maybe this is in fact the tricky idea. And if Knight C5 now, I can take E5. It's maybe quite okay for Black. Yeah, it's all about this great knight on d5. Now this looks like a strange move. Yeah, okay, I'll trap the knight now. Now there's even rook d8 immediately threatened. Bishop d8, there was rook c8. I need to prepare that. So now bishop d8 takes, rook takes, and it is trapped. As simple as that. And bishop d8, if white plays any move, I take g5, play rook d8, and again it's trapped. Yeah, I think I'm just ruining the knight. As weird as it is, it's trapped. Yeah, I think she's not finding any solution to this problem and therefore spending so much time. This knight really got lost inside of Black's camp.
Check.
Yeah. Relatively, I mean, okay, it's relatively easy now. I block the c pawn, rook b8 coming. It's an easy technical task. Yeah, this was very, very strange, huh? Quite out of the blue. I was winning. Yeah, well, I can take with the rook as well. Yeah, come on, get it to b8. I can always grab material. Rook b8 to b5.
White resigns.
Yeah, this was strange. Very strange game. It really, I don't know. I mean, Black shouldn't be in trouble. I'm pretty optimistic about that. But it's very tricky because my rook h8 is not playing. And what I did here, yeah, maybe there, maybe White has some way to play it more precisely. Maybe rook c4 here, for example.
Check.
I mean, this is not losing or anything. No doubt. But probably knight d7 is really not the best idea.
Check.
It looks tempting, but yeah, after b4 is really losing. Such a harmless looking move. The computer immediately goes on black winning here because after bishop c7, now knight c5 is the only move not losing the knight, and this drops the e5 pawn. So this is the relatively best continuation, but it's the super important e5 pawn. And after that, yeah, it's really lost this piece.
Check.
Quite remarkable. Yeah, the Caro Kann is an immensely solid opening, really. But,
Check.
yeah, so this should be equalish. Maybe something like this is what improves taking control here. But still, if I just play rook here, let's check. Yeah, The space, I need to go all the way back or to e7, which is slightly annoying. And if I go here, something like g4. Yeah, white keeps some edge here. This, for example, can lead to a passer. Yeah, white can certainly improve in the opening. Maybe this c5 move, which I really liked, is not such a great idea. Yeah, well, it's not a correspondence game. Can analyze it more deeply. Thanks for watching.